Good evening to all. I feel extremely honored to introduce the chief guest of today's session, Dr. G. Puthilibai ma'am, Professor, Department of Chemistry, Sri Sairam Engineering College, Chennai. Her education qualification includes she has completed MSc, MPhil, BEd, PGDC, and she has completed PhD. Also, she has got 26 years of teaching experience with additional responsibilities like she is a coordinator of IPR Cell and MOE's IAC Innovation Ambassador. Regarding her postdoctoral research experience, she is postdoctoral research fellow at the University of Russia, Moscow, Russia in 2010, and postdoctoral research fellowship Russia State Medical University 2011. And she has a membership in professional bodies like she is a life member of and Society for Technical Education, and also Researchers Society of Chemical Sciences, and also a life member of Institute for Engineering Research and Publication. Her achievements include she has got a number of patents granted is 24, and she is an UG college topper as well as rank holder in PG level. She has also received Best Going Student Award, and she has won championship for sports games activities in PG level. And successfully, she has participated in keynote speaker and session chair for the world record event of 150 hours continuous presentation, and recognized by Indian record for the achievement of maximum patent filed together in a single day by individual various innovative institutions. And she is a national topper in four courses patent drafting conducted by NPTEL and IIT Madras. She has received a best mentor several times for the excellent mentoring of students online MOOC courses conducted by NPTEL in association with IIT AICT. And she has received Young Women Scientist Award by Dr. Kalam Educational Trust. And also she has received Award of Excellence from Raman and Ramanujam Awards 2020 of Ratnam College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. And she has been nominated for Bharat Purushkar Award by India National Friendship Society. And also she has nominated for Best Citizen Award by Global Economic Progress and Research. And regarding her publication, she has published 6 books so far. And number of publications including conference and proceedings are 60. She has acted as a resource person for 28 sessions. A number of programs organized by her is 14, and she has attended so many FDPs, conferences, seminars of 82, and she has completed online courses of 121. And we are very happy to have you as a resource person, ma'am, for this wonderful session. Thank you, ma'am.
First of all, let me explain what is intellectual property. So generally, properties can be classified into two types. One is a tangible property, otherwise known as a physical property or visible property. The other one is intangible property or invisible property, which is otherwise known as intellectual property. So how the physical properties we are registering on our name? For example, if we buy a house or a land, so what we used to do, even after paying the money worth for the property, whether we can say that we are the owner of the property? So actually, no. So after registering on our name only, we can say that the property is belongs to me. Similarly, if we buy a two-wheeler or four-wheeler, what we used to do, we used to go to the RTO office. So there we used to register in our name. Similarly, to protect the intellectual property, that is invisible property, so we can protect our intellectual property on our name by registering our intellectual property, so any kind of innovation, with the intellectual property right office. So these are the various components of intellectual property. Intellectual property actually widely which is classified into two types. One is industrial property, the other one is copyrights and related rights. Industrial property can be further classified into patents, industrial design, trademarks or trade service, trade secrets, geographical indications, layout designs of semiconductor ICs, plant varieties and farmers' right. So these are the various components of intellectual property rights. So this copyright and related rights, whatever may be the department or the branch we belongs to, we can file our invention or whatever we want to protect, all those things we can protect under copyrights. And the other part of the intellectual property, that is industrial property, so among the various components of intellectual property, this patent is the most and the prime important component, and it is very difficult to claim also. And the next one is industrial design, next trademarks, and it goes on. And let me explain one by one in detail. So before explaining the various components, I'll give a simple example. The example is a ring pull technology for beverage cans. So to open the beverage cans, whatever may be the beverage cans, nowadays everybody, we cannot say that we have not used, everybody we used to use this technology, ring pull technology, to open the beverage cans. Statistics says that 160 million cans opened per day. So if we see the royalty of one unit, that is a one bottle ring pull technology, it is around 0.1 penny. So okay, it accounts more than rupees 1 crore per day. So the person who protected his inventive, this simple technology, so since he protected, he is earning more than rupees 1 crore as the royalty per day. So from the simple example, hello? From this simple example, we can understand how important the intellectual property and the intellectual property should be protected. Similarly, for each and every small technology, we can protect. For filing patents or any kind of intellectual property, there is no age limit or there is no minimum qualification too. So now let me try to explain the various components. Let us start with the patents. Let me explain what is patent. Patent is a statutory right to the inventor or the applicant by the government for his invention, which is either a process or product. We can file a patent either for a process or for a product. So if it is mathematics, the mathematical calculations, it has to be integrated with some hardware. Accordingly, we have to combine, or we have to merge with, or we have to do the interdisciplinary research. So by the way, we can file a patents. So ultimately, to file a patent, so the invention should be either a process or a product. It is for the limited period of time. Once we get the grant of the patent, if our invention is granted, the period of protection is 20 years. So from the date of filing, which will be protected only up to 20 years, and after 20 years, it will automatically come to the public and everybody can use it. We cannot say that it's my property, it's my intellectual property I have protected. So it is only a limited period of time. It is granted in lieu of sufficient disclosures to the patent offices. So the grant of any invention will be given only after the submission of the sufficient disclosures. So all the details related to the inventions we have to submit, and the examiner of the patent office, they will examine thoroughly, and they will raise the queries, are is there any clarifications, and after the clarification only which will be a given grant. It is only territorial right. For example, if we file a patent in Indian patent office, which will be protected within India. For example, if we feel that our invention is more valuable in some other country, so we have to keep explore. And what are all the countries they are very familiar, or they are using this type of product or the process. So in that country, if we want to protect, we have to file the PCT applications. So PCT applications, once we file, which will be protected worldwide. So PCT means a patent cooperation treaty, or else if we want to protect only few more countries through the PCT applications, by mentioning that countries we can apply and we can protect our invention. So otherwise, if we file and if we get a grant in Indian patent office, and which will be protected only within India. To file a patent, what is a patent, or what are all the conditions it has to be fulfilled, or what are all the conditions for patentability? So before filing a patent, we have to ensure that whether our invention will fulfill these three conditions: novelty, non-obviousness or inventiveness, and third one is industrial applications, otherwise known as utility. Among the three conditions, it is very easy to satisfy the third condition. So whatever may be the process or the product, definitely some application will be there. And somehow we can satisfy, or we can arrive the first condition also. Somehow we can prove the novelty also. So before explaining, let me explain what is novelty. So novelty means it should be new. The invention must not be published in India or elsewhere. In prior public knowledge or prior public use within India, it should not be published, or it should not be in use in any part of the India or in any part of the world. See, if it is used in any part of the world also, we cannot protect even within India. But if we protect within India, that is, if we file in India, we can protect only within India. But to protect our property within India, it should not be published elsewhere, that is all over the world. Then claimed before in any specification in India, in any form, it should not be claimed in any form. It should not be, say for example, our product, if we might have presented through the conferences also, we cannot say that it's our property. It should be already in the prior art. It should be in the public domain. So it should be new at the time of filing a patent. So that's what, before filing a patent, we should not reveal our process or the product in any form. After filing a patent only, we can publish in any form. A next condition is inventive step. So inventive, what is inventive? Means it involves, it should have some technical advancements as compared to the existing knowledge. So exactly which product we are trying to protect. So we have to make a prior art search, and we have to try to find out all the related details in what way our product is advantageous, in particular technologically advantageous. So that we have to find out. So it should have technological advancements, it should have economic significance, or it can be both, and makes the invention not obvious to a person skilled in the art. So it should not be obvious to a person skilled in the art. So somebody, if they come across about our invention, they should not feel that what is this, which is already existing, the same type of technology or the product somewhere else I have seen. So like that, they should not feel. And simply, they should not. We should not steal the other's process, or we should not simply copy the process. So all these things, it comes under inventive step. So it should be inventive. And the third one is industrial applications. Fulfilling the second step is very difficult. Most of the filed patents are getting failure, and which will be abandoned only because of not satisfying the second step. Next is a process of patenting. So during patenting, that's what I told, be curious, but do not disclose your invention anywhere. So instead, what you have to, once you planned to patent, what you have to do, you should not disclose about your invention. Instead, you have to do, instead, you have to take a bound notebook, and one by one, you have to note down your ideas, and slowly, slowly, you have to develop your ideas, and finally, you have to produce a model, and always, you have to write why your invention is needed, what is the existing products are in the market, your new product and what is unique about your product. So all these questions always you have to ask, and the related points you have to note down, and finally you have to come to the conclusion. That conclusion, it has to fulfill the above three conditions. What are all they? Novelty, inventiveness, and industrial applications. So what are all the patent rights? After getting the grant of the patent, what are all the rights we have to protect or to prevent third party without authorization to make or manufacture, to use, offering for sale? We can sell, we can import, we can distribute, we can get a license, or we can sell the license. So these are all the rights after getting the grant of the patent. And next is what are all the subjects or subject matter can be patentable. So actually all the products and processes are not patentable. So what are all the subject matters are patentable? Any article, any apparatus, or any machinery, or its components of machinery, any substance, whether it is living or non-living, it can be a pharmaceutical product, or it can be a composition of matter, or it can be a process or manner or art of manufacturing, but other than the essential biological processes. So these are the list of things or the inventions which are not patentable. So in general, any contrary to the natural laws. For example, we know Pythagoras theorem. So if you try to prove that the theorem is wrong, that is not patentable, then contrary to public order or mortality, mere scientific principles or abstract theory, any new forms of known substances, new properties of known substances, method of treatment, method of agriculture, method of playing game, then plant or animal parts except the microorganisms, business method or computer program per se. So computer program per se means mere computer program, mere algorithm is not patentable, but it is copyrighted. And at the same time, if we try to integrate this computer program with the hardware, then it is patentable. Then copyrightable products, simply literary work, dramatic work, artistic work, which is not patentable. Then admixture of substances. So the known substances, simply if we try to mix and if we try to claim that which will be having different properties or different applications, that is not patentable. Then presentation of informations, mere presentation of information is not patentable. Topography of integrated circuit is not patentable. So as such, ICs are patentable, but topography, that is mere topography, is not patentable. Traditional knowledge is not patentable. Or anything or any research which is related to defense, which is not patentable. And anything which is related to radioactive substances, that is not patentable. Next is how to file the patent applications. There are two ways of filing patent applications. One is a physical filing, which will be done at the patent office. So for that, directly we can go to the patent office with the necessary forms, enclosures, and the fee. Then we can file our patents there. The other form is online, that is electronic patent filing, which is introduced only in the year 2007. So for that, we have to have a licensed digital signature. So we have to see if we are going to file only one patent. So then directly we can go to the patent office and we can file. Otherwise, if we have many numbers of inventions, then we can get a licensed signature. The thing is, we have to pay the money for getting the licensed signature also. So instead of that, straight away we can go to the patent office if it is only one. Otherwise, if it is more number of patents, we can get a license of our signature and then we can file from our home itself. Then where to file the patent applications? So there are four patent offices in India. Among the head office is at Calcutta, and this filing of patent applications is territorial. Since we belongs to Tamil Nadu, we can file our patent applications only at Chennai. So the territorial jurisdictions of Chennai patent office is the states from Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and the union territories of Pondicherry and Lakshadweep. Similarly, for each and every patent office, so there is a territorial jurisdictions. So only from those states only they can file the patents. And the miscellaneous places, so they can file their patents at head office. And anybody can file our patents at head office. So these are the essential requirements while drafting our invention. So the drafting of inventions, so here we used to say complete specifications. It should contain the following ingredients, right from the title and the preamble. Then prayer art. Here the prayer art is nothing but the literature review in our journal writing. Then drawbacks and prayer art. Efforts are solutions to prior arts, summary of the invention, statement of invention, and then detailed description of invention. Under this heading, whatever the subheadings we want to give and we want to explain about the process or the product, all those things we can accommodate under this. Then detailed description with respect to drawings. So if we have drawings and tables or graphs, all those descriptions we have to give. Is there any examples we can give? And at last, we have to give the claims. So why I have highlighted this claim? So the claim part of the specification is the most important form. And after filing a patent, after the thorough examination, so finally we will be getting a grant for our claims and not for the description or the complete specification. Only for the claims only we will be getting grant. Sometimes if we file 10, if we claim 10 claims, so instead of 10 claims, they may neglect or they may, they may prove that which is already existing. So if you are not able to claim that, for example, 2 claims, and for the remaining 8 claims, we will be given grant. So always before drafting, before writing the complete specifications, so we have to do the thorough prayer art analysis. So that I'll explain later how to do the prayer art. And we have to find out the drawbacks in the prayer art. So in the existing technology, what are all the drawbacks are there? For the drawbacks, we have to try to give the solution. So we have to give the effort to rectify the drawbacks. And accordingly, we have to proceed and we have to develop our invention. So that's what already I told. This claim is the most important part. While drafting the claim, we have to be very careful and we must know what is claim, how to write a claim. So generally, claims can be broadly classified into 4 types. Based on the drafting, there will be a set of claims. Based on the invention we can give, based on the field, based on the structure. So the 4th type is purely which is related to the structure and which is related to chemistry. And the 1st type, that is based on the drafting. So we can adopt this type of claim writing for any field, for any branch of invention, we can adopt this type of claim writing. That is independent claim, dependent claim, and omnibus claim. Independent claim means always the 1st claim will be independent claim. And the 2nd one is dependent claim. Always the dependent claims depends on some other claims. An omnibus claim is the, for example, if you give a broad scope, say for example, this product is useful in the aeronautical engineering. This is useful in the manufacturing process. So like that, we should not give a claim. We have to specify. So okay, omnibus claim is claiming the broad opportunity or the broad spectrum of our product or the process. That is not acceptable in the Indian patenting system, but it can be accepted under PCT applications. Next is based on the product or process or apparatus or use. It is based on invention, we can write a claims. Or based on the field, that is gypsum claim, Marcus claim, Swiss claim. So these are the claims based on the fields. For example, for a particular product, so we have some applications. If we try to find out some other applications for the existing thing, so all those things, it comes under field type of claims. Sometimes we'll be having one product, and if we try to find out the different properties, so simply if we give one or two properties, that is not acceptable. Even if it is one or two properties, if we try to satisfy the three conditions, then it is patentable. So, okay, for each and every property, new property or the new use or the new field of applications, so if you try to prove the novelty, inventiveness and applications, then it is patentable. So all those things, it comes under field type of claim writing. So this is what the claim anatomy or the claim structure. Actually, while writing the claim, which will be divided into three parts. One is preamble, and the last one is main body, and in between there is a linking word. So method for promoting weight and fat loss in an individual in need, it comes under preamble. Then whatever the claims we want to claim in our invention, all those things we have to include broadly in the first claim, that is called independent claim. And in between there is a linking word. It's always which will be comprising, which contains, like that. So next to linking one, linking word, whatever the inventions, the different parts or the different components of inventions, one by one with comma or colon we can add up. So this is what the different patent forms. Actually there are nearly 30 forms are available. So while filing initially, we have to file form 1, form 2, form 3, form 5. And for the early publication, we can file form 9. For the request for examination, we have to file form 18. Form 1 is the application of grant, and form 2 is for the submission of provisional or complete specification. So you know what is complete specification. I'll try to explain what is provisional specification later. Then the form 2 is for a statement and undertaking. Form 5 is to declare the inventors, declaration as to inventorship. And if we file a patent through the patent agent or the attorney, we have to file patent form 26. For the miscellaneous, we can use form 30. If we file through the startup, or if we file as a women inventor, then we can file form 18A. So these are all the various forms which will be used in the different stages of patent prosecution. So these are all the fees which is related to the various forms. Along with the form 1, so actually the fees is divided into three categories. If we file as a natural person or the individual, then it comes under natural person. And the next one is MSME or small scale industry. And the third one is MNCs and large scale industries. Large scale entrepreneurship. So all those things, if we file our patent in the name of our college, it comes under the third category. Or else, if we file our patents in our name with the college affiliation, then it comes under the first category, under natural person. See, if we compare the fees, all the fees for the natural person and the MNCs, which is nearly about 3 to 4 times. So the same fees difference will be there for each and every forms. Along with the form 1, we have to pay 1,600. For request for examination, it is 4,000. The same thing, if it is a college, instead of 1,600, we have to pay 8,000. For a request for examination, we have to pay 20,000. So, like that. For each and every form, the fees will be like that. So, all these fees, we can get it from the patent office site. That is www.ipindia.nic.in. So, this is what the patent anatomy of US patent publication page, which contains all the informations right from the first inventor, patent title, the other inventors, assignee or the owner of the patent. So it is not necessary that always we have to assign somebody else. So even we ourselves, we can file a patent. We need not to assign anybody. Then application number, patent filing date, details of related US patent applications, then IPC class, international patent classification, then US class. So what is IPC, that I'll explain later. Then backward patent citation. So this is more or less like a references, that is a references cited. Then patent number, grant date, non-patent citations. This is non-patent literature review. Then patent examiner, patent attorney, agent or firm, and abstract. So all those things will be displayed in a single page. And this page is the publication page of our Indian patent system. This is one of my published patent. So there in the top, we'll be having all the official details, that is application number, date of application, publication date, next is title, and then the left hand side we have all international patent filing details, and the right hand side, so we have the name of the applicants. For the for the first applicant only, the full address will be displayed, and for other applicants only the name will be displayed, even for the inventors. But for the other applicants and the inventors, the applications will be entered in their internal register. Next is abstract, total number of pages, number of claims. So already I was explaining about the patent fee details. So this with this minimum fee, we can submit maximum up to 30 pages and 10 claims. And it is not necessary that we have to stick on, otherwise we have to file only within this many pages, within 30 pages or 10 claims. So even we can extend, but for each and every page and the claim, we need to pay the extra page fee. For the minimum fee, we can file maximum up to 30 pages and 10 claims. And at last, we'll be having a patent journal volume, year, and then page number. So this is what the granted certificate for the same published patent. This is what the grant certificate. In the grant certificate, the grant certificate will be given for the name of the individual, and the affiliation will be given as the annexure or the information page, which will not be displayed in the certificate. And very clearly, they will be mentioning about the invention. So this is for the simple graphical representation of patent granting procedure. So initially, filing of patent applications, and then there will be a publication. After the publication, there is an examination, and then application grant. After the grant also, there is a publication. And before and after the examination, there will be opposition also. So any public, if they want to oppose, so okay, this invention is related to us, or any kind of opposition, they can raise. And this is possible both before and after the examination. Even after the grant also, anybody can oppose. So this is what the detailed patent granting system in India. So this chart explains the overall process of Indian patenting system. So initially, conceptualization of an invention. So this we have given in a single word or sentence. So actually, it comes actually in this first point only. All our research and all conclusions, all the results, everything which will include it. And next is based on that there will be a filing of application. So there are two types of filing of applications. One is provisional specifications. The other one is complete specifications. So that's what already I told. I'll explain about the provisional specification later. So if we have all the complete results of our invention, then straight away we can file as a complete specification. So otherwise, if some of the results are pending, and to observe the results, sometimes for a particular study, it will take some time, then we can go for provisional specifications. So even after the completion, we can go for a complete specification. Why we have to go for a provisional specification? Only because of one or two results, we need not to wait. So within that, if somebody else in any part of our any part of the world, if they filed a patent with those results, the results what we are waiting, so all those things, it comes under that is what for we are waiting. Those with those results, if somebody else, if they file a patent, then they will be the owner of the product or the process. So instead, if we file a provisional specifications with the results what we are having, then we will be the owner of the product or the process. So that's what, to claim the early date, we have to go for a provisional specification. And within 1 year after filing, that is within 1 year or after filing, before 1 year or 12 months, we have to file a complete specification of the provisional results what we have submitted. If not, automatically the application will be abandoned. Or else, if we file a patent, then automatically it will go the procedure as similar to the submission of the complete specifications. So after the submission of complete specifications, which will be published in the Patent Office Journal, that is the Gazette of the Patent Office Journal. And for this also, we can give a yearly request. For that also, we have to pay the necessary fee, and we have to file a form also. For that, we have to use Form 9, and which will be published immediately. And we have to give the request for examination. Based on the request for examination, there will be examination. And before that, there is a possibility of opposition also, that is called pre-grant opposition. Or else, it will go to the examination. After the thorough examination, based on the examination results, FER will be issued. That is a first examination report. This first examination report is nothing but the reviewer's report of our journal publications. And we have to amend this FER issued by the controller of examinations. If it is amended properly, again it will go for the re-examination. If the controller is satisfied, it will be granted. So otherwise, they will raise the second examination report. Either if they are not satisfied, simply they can abandon or they can object. Otherwise, they will raise the second examination report, SER also. Again, we have to try to convince them, we have to reply, and based on that again they'll go for the examination, and it goes on the procedure. If we failed to file or amend the FER reply, automatically it will be abandoned without any notification. Here the patent office, from the patent office, we will not get any notification. We ourselves, we have to follow the stages where we are. If it is totally satisfied by the controller of examinations, and which will be granted finally. So these are the some of the patent sites. That's what I told. No, always before filing a patent, we have to ensure that, so whether this product or the process is already existing or not. If it is existing, so based on the prior art, we have to try to find out the drawbacks, or we have to try to find out, we have to try to bring some kind of novelty and the inventiveness. So for that we have to work. So these are the some of the patent sites. So patent scope. So this site is related to WIPO, that is World Intellectual Property Organization. Under this site we will be getting information almost from all over the country. Then eSpace.net, actually the site is eSpace.net. So this site also, which contains the patent databases from all countries. And next one is USPTO.gov. So this patent site is related to US, and EPO is related to European Patent Office. Then ipindia.nac.in is related to Indian Patent Office. So here only you will get all the information, so all the already filed patent informations. Freepatents.net, freepatents.net is there. Then one more site is freepatentsonline.com, patentstamp.com. This patentstamp is one of the oldest patent reference sites, serving information about the current, pending and expired US and world patents. And apart from that, so instead of doing this search from the various countries through the various websites, if we want to have a single point of search, so better either we can go for a Google Patents or Advanced Google Patents. So over a period of time, this Google Patents started working on coverage, and now it indexes more than 87 million patents with full text from the patent offices of 17 different countries, which includes US, Europe, China, Japan, Korea, then in general, World Intellectual Property Organizations, WIPO, then Deutsch, which is related to German Patent Office, Canada, and the patent data from various other patent offices of countries, which includes Russia, UK, France, Spain, Belgium, Denmark, Finland, Luxembourg, and the Netherlands. So the best site is Google Patents. So after going through the Google Patents, after narrowing down of our results, we can go for Advanced Google Patents. And one more thing, instead of going through this patent official websites, so even through the official websites, if we try to get a literature review, that is a prior art literature, there also we will be getting millions of results. So we know through Google, if we search, we will be getting millions of results. It is very difficult to find out the inventions which is very related or very closer to our invention. So it will take more time. So for that, what we can do is we can do the that is a classification code analysis for each and every patent applications. After filing at patent office, immediately they will classify our application. So based on the field, they will classify. Say for example, if the classification code, if it starts from the letter G, this G is related to physics. So whatever may be the branches or the applications, all the patent filed applications will be broadly classified into 7 categories. And that one of the categories, for example, that is a physics. Then if we add 06, which is related to computing, calculating and counting. For mathematics, there is no separate branch, like how they have started G for physics. But in all the 7 fields, the mathematics are related. So we have to try to find out in which field are, that is your research or your findings are related to which field. So accordingly, we have to choose. So if we add 06, then it is related to computing or calculating. And again, if we add N, which is related to computer systems, that is based on specific computational models. And then if you add 3-BOS-00, which is related to biological models, like that it goes on. So in which field you are trying to file a patent, that is you have to find out your field of invention For that, you have to find out this classification code. So with the help of this classification code, if we try to do the prior art search, which is very easy to narrow down and which is very easy to go ahead further and which will save our time also. And this is a patent application number analysis for each and every patent office. Say for example, if any patent number, if it starts with the letter W, we can understand that it is a worldwide patent which is filed through PCT applications. All PCT applications will be maintained by WIPO. This is international applications. Then EP, European application, JP, Japan, China, Taiwan, US, Korea, like that. So in front of the application number, there will be a abbreviation of their country. For Indian, the first one belongs to the Indian patent application. Up to 2014, this was the the Indian patent numbering system. And from the 2015, the numbering system is like this. The first four digits starts from the year of filing, and the next three digits refers to the patent office. Actually, 410 is the Indian patent office, 412 is the Delhi patent office, like that. So earlier system is, that is, the four digit number is the Indian patent application number, and then the place of filing, and then the year. So in the 2015 onwards, so this is what the patent numbering system, and the next five digits, it represents the serial number. And after the number, so we can find A2, AI, B2, the C, B. So these letters represents with prior art or without prior art, before grant, after grant, with publications or without publications. So based on that, similarly, from these databases, we can understand that so what will be the patent filing worldwide, how the contribution of the various countries in terms of patent filings. So in terms of patent filing worldwide, China tops the position. The China approximately 1.5 million patent applications are filing every year, and their contribution is 11.6. US filing, their contribution is 1.6. And if you try to find out, see, this China alone, they are filing 1.5 million patent applications, and this magnitude is more or less equal to the next, that is a combined total of next 10 patent offices, next 10 countries. And if we try to find out our India, somewhere we are in the seventh position in terms of numbers, but anyway, our contribution is 7.5. So this is what the statistics in terms of number of patent applications. And next one is in terms of GDP, if we try to have statistics, so there are there the Republic of Korea tops the position, next is China and Japan, and goes on like that. And if we try to find out our India, actually we are not listed in the top 10. And if you have a statistics based on the PCT applications, that too, filing the PCT applications at US, that is, US contribution is 56,142, and the China is 53, which is almost near to the US. So it says that the China is filing more number of patents. They are filing they are protecting their inventions at US. But if we see the percentage of contribution of US is around 1%, but China is around 9%. See, China is filing more number of patents at US. And in this list also, if we try to find out our India, we are not listed in the top 10. And this statistics, which says, so based on the technology, say if we have a Huawei technology, So based on the technology, based on the technology, if we try to have a data, so in the top 10 PCT applications, this Huawei technology tops the position. And next is Intel and then Samsung, and it goes on. And this is based on the top 10 patent applications awarded in US. So in this list, if we see the first place, the first position of the filing of patent applications in terms of here the awards is mainly based on the number of patent applications, and at the same time how much grant or the loyalty they are getting, and based on that which will be given. And see, if the first position goes to the software related companies. Next to software only medical. So actually the softwares are not patentable in India, but in US, if you see among the top 10, the software company only which is topping the position. And next is medical, chemical, computer, drugs, like that. So that's all about patenting. When we talk about patenting, we must remember this youngest patent holder on wheelchair. So he is from Jaipur, drawing the inspiration from the scientist Stephen Hawking. He is a wheelchair bound 9 years old boy. Here he has invented a game of 6-player circular chess. His name is Haridyaswar Singh Bhati, and he filed a patent for his game design, and he got a grant also in his name. Next is the other components of IPRs: industrial designs, trademarks, copyrights and related rights, then GA, geographical indications, and at last plant varieties. Next, let us discuss a brief. I am not going to discuss in depth about the industrial designs. I will give a brief outline about the industrial designs. This industrial designs will be filed and will be given a grant only for the ornamental or aesthetic appearance or the aspects of any useful articles. It can be either based on its shape, pattern, or color combination. It must have a visual appeal. Visually, it should be different. Articles must be reproducible by industrial means. We have to specify the dimensions. It should be reproducible means, so each and every time when we manufacture, there should not be any variation in its dimensions. So accordingly, we have to give a clear picture about the dimensions also, and we need not to specify about the material, using which material we are going to design the industrial design. And these are all some of the examples of designs. So we cannot believe that, for example, more than thousands of designs we have for this glass tumblers. And next is intellectual property rights. The next component is trademarks or trade services, and which will be displayed with the help of the letters either TM or right at the top right corner. After getting the grant of this trademarks, we can use the letter R, otherwise TM. So what for we have to use, we have to get this trademarks? To identify the components, to identify to understand about the standard. For example, from this symbol, wherever if we see or if we come across, immediately we can understand that it's a pizza corner. So even if we don't know about the letters, the meaning of the letters, in some of the trademarks there will not be any letters. So from the symbol itself, we can understand that this product is related to this thing. And this is copyrights. So with the help of this copyrights, all the rights can be reserved. So whatever may be the field, irrespective of the field, everything can be protected under copyright. So these are all some of the major parts which will be protected under copyright. So generally, if you see literary work, artistic work, or any databases, or computer programs, or algorithms, so all those things which will be protected under copyright. Literary works, it includes any kind of literary work. It can be a story, it can be a play, poem, novel, letter, etc., or maintenance, even instruction manuals. Then published edition of works. For example, we can there is a published book publication. It comes under this category. Then photographs. Then works of fine arts, painting, sculptures, cartoon, logo, all electronic databases. Then computer programs, which includes softwares and algorithms. Even the mathematical calculations can be protected under this category. And if we try to find out, or if we try to integrate this thing with the hardware, then it is patentable. And with the help of mathematical calculations, if we try to give a dimensions for a design, then it comes under industrial design. So these are the six different parts of copyrights. So whatever may be the copyrights we are trying to protect, so which will be categorized in any one of this six category. Part A, which includes literary works, that is other than computer programs. The computer programs comes under the last part, part F. Then part B, musical works. Part C, artistic works. Then part D, cinematography film. And part E, sound recording. This is what the copyright registration. So the registration of copyright is comparatively very easy when compared with the patent filing and the execution procedure. For a normal patent or the technology patent is a bit complicated and it is lengthy procedure. Instead, if you want to protect anything under copyright, it is very easy to protect only one form with the annexes, the two kinds of annexes we have to submit, and depends upon the domain. So we have to pay the application fee. If it is under literary, artistic, musical, or dramatic work, so we have to pay rupees 500 per work. Or if it is related to cinematography film, it is 5,000 per work. If it is a recording, it is 2,000 per work. This copyright is protected 70 years after the death of the copyrighted person. But the patent is valid only for the 20 years, that too from the filing of patent applications. After filing of patent applications to get grant, sometimes it may take 5 years or even 7 years. So excluding that, for example, if it is 5 years, excluding that 5 years, we will be having right only for the remaining 15 years. And after that, automatically it will come to the public domain. We cannot say that it's our property, anybody can use. So that's what, once we file the patent, immediately we have to do the technology transfer, and immediately we have to find out the right place, and we have to try to get at the maximum. And next is geographical indications. So geographical indications, one of the best example is Darjeeling tea. So anything, if it is originated from our nation, then we can say that it's RGI, or geographical indications. And some more examples are Champagne, Darjeeling tea, Alfonso mango. Then local examples, Tirunelveli Alva, Tirupati Laddu, then Kanjipuram Silk Sari. So all these things, it comes under geographical indications. geographical vindication is used to identify goods having special characteristics and originating from a definite geographical territory, and the law which is related to this GA is GA Act 1999. And next is the plant varieties protection. So this is most important part nowadays. It is necessary, or we have to give more importance or need for protection of plant breeders. So hereafter, then that is the wealth of the nation will be decided by this plant protection. So we have to protect our plant and its varieties. This is also a kind of intellectual property. And at last is a traditional knowledge. In short, we used to say TK. So this traditional knowledge is not protected under individual, but it can be protected at the patent office. So if we fail to protect this traditional knowledge, what will happen? So this traditional knowledge, anybody can patent. For example, the people from any other countries, they can patent our property. So for example, the best example to understand this is haldi, that is turmeric. In Tamil, we used to say manjal. So this turmeric is, we know it is, traditionally we are using it. It belongs to our country, which is originated from our country, but it is patented by US. So after several years ago, we came to know that it is patented by US. Then we have tried to prove that it is our property, and somewhere else in the old journal, in the old article, it was written that this turmeric is having antibacterial or the wound healing property, and so based on that we have revoked. But for that we spend a lot of money, and finally we have revoked, and now it belongs to our property. So nowadays, for that, what we are doing is we are protecting under traditional knowledge. So at the patent office, there is a dictionary like traditional knowledge will be there. But this traditional knowledge, sometimes because of unawareness, that is a traditional knowledge means group oriented and tradition based past, present and future manifestations of groups or individuals of their society and cultural identity. It encompasses the cultural, intellectual, religious and spiritual properties. But this TK is non-available at the abroad countries. That's what, for example, even the same turmeric case, if the US, they tried to file a patent, and they got the grant also. So, but they don't know it is a traditional knowledge of India. So that's what, even if we protect our traditional knowledge at the patent office, the abroad country or the people from other nations, they are not aware. So because of that unawareness, sometimes they are filing patents, and which will be granted also. And the informations are not available in the international languages. Even if they come to find out what are all the things which is protected under traditional knowledge. So anyway, in India, we are using English as the language. In some other countries, they are using their own languages. So that's what, because of non-availability of this international languages, sometimes they are unaware, and unknowingly they are filing patents in the other countries. So from this machine, we can understand that how many intellectual properties are protected. So this is a camera. So here, four different intellectual properties we can see. That is a patent. The patent is for the technological advancements, the new technology used in this instrument. For that, we can protect and under patent. And the trademark is for the letter Canon, which is written. So okay, the size, the way, the style of and the color used to write, which will be reproduced always. So this can be protected under trademark. And next is the design. Design is for the appearance of the camera. And the fourth component is the copyright. Copyright is for the instruction manual. So the same instrument, if we file under, if we file in the name of camera, which will be protected only to capture the photos of a person. The same thing, if we file or if we give a title as picture capturing machine, then we can protect our any machine in future to take a picture of any kind. Even it may be an image processing type of instrument, then it comes under our claim. So we will be the owner in future. So that's what the way of writing the patent specifications. And next is Government of India's national policy related to IPR, and which is implemented in the year 2016. It's Creative India, Innovative India. Under this, Make in India, Digital India, Smart Cities, Skilled India. So hereafter, that is the country's GDP and the country's wealth will be decided by our intellectual property. That's what our Government of India started creating awareness about the intellectual property and how to protect the intellectual property. So everybody should aware of this importance of intellectual property. So conclusion, we are in the era of knowledge economy. Knowledge management is the key to success. Information or patents, information on patents can be used to meet the challenge of growing competition. Our industry needs to become IPR survey. We can meet the challenge of growing competition in the WTO, World Trade Organization era, through use of knowledge of patents and other IPRs. Basic knowledge of IPR is essential for engineers, scientists, managers, and all academicians. So we people, what we used to do, so we are good at knowledge, we are very sound in our subjects. At the maximum, what we used to do, we used to do our standard research, and at the maximum we'll try to publish in the very standard journals, are the journals having very high impact factor. And most of the people, they are unaware, and they don't bother about this intellectual property. They don't file a patent even. So until you file a patent, you cannot say that it's our property. So once your research output, if you publish, so based on the results, some modifications or some changes anybody can do, and they can file their the inventions or the modified research, and they'll protect under their name. So that's what protecting the intellectual property, that is the rights, is the most important thing, and which will be decided, that is which will decide the that is a knowledge economy, that is the economy of our country. Thank you all.